final word count from ChatGPT was 1,762. And the final word count from Google Gemini was, wow. Hey, welcome to this video. I have written these books. I actually have more books that I've written using AI. I started when ChatGPT first was introduced. These are real physical copies, all of them, on Amazon using their Amazon KDP, the Kindle Publishing Network. And I'm going to show you in this video here how exactly I did that, because there are some tricks and a little bit of some secrets, maybe not so secret, but what's cool now versus when I wrote this one, for example, which has got a lot of words, it's really big. This was the first iteration of ChatGPT that I wrote with. And then, for example, let me just show you this one back here. I should have done this. This is a picture book. This was all Midjourney that I did this on. And it's beautiful. But now I actually did Midjourney. This was before you could do text on images even. And now you could do way cooler things. And these, it's really beautiful, all of the pictures. So how I did this, though, is easily just by going to an AI LLM, typing in whatever you want, right? But when I was doing it before, I didn't have access to deep research. And that is a major thing for anybody today, because what you can do with deep research is crazy. So if you don't know what deep research is, you can click on it. You can see right here on the bottom, it says run deep research. And then you can click on that. And then when you search on it, it's going to, so I typed in how to write a book using AI and publish on KDP, the Kindle Direct Publishing Network. Went ahead and spit out all of this incredible content, which isn't a full book yet, but if you go over to Google Gemini, I did the same thing. So with all of the ChatGPT, all the LLMs, whatever AI you're talking to, you can go and do deep research on them, get them to write about any topic, and then it's going to come and look how many words it creates. And these are all real words, real things. It's really incredible. You can actually go and export documents if you're using Google Gemini, which probably the best to do now because Google really is at the top. And so let's see how many words this actually gave us here. Word count is, it wrote almost 7,000 words by just one prompt, which was the same, which was just, I want to, how to write a book using AI and publish on Amazon KDP, right? So it wrote me 7,000 words. Now, that's a lot of words, honestly. So you could even get it to write more if you wanted to. That's how I've done this book here, which is I went chapter by chapter in the Bible and added commentary based off of training AI on a particular message and type of theology called sonship. And what it does is it adds a comment. So I went chapter by chapter and just was copying and pasting all of this stuff into AI to be able to get this, right? This is not based off of deep research, but it still is actually really good. But really what I'm talking about is doing this type of deep research, which then you could turn into a book almost immediately. You just need to go through here and maybe get rid of some stuff. It has all these footnotes in here and stuff, which is really cool. It has all the tables in there, which is really cool. So the tricks that I have is really very simple. First of all, your paper size, you can straight directly change the size, but this is the only standard size that they have listed besides larger one here, that actually you can directly just download a PDF. So you could download this PDF if it's 5.5 by 8.5 and then go over to Amazon here, right? This is the Amazon Kindle Publishing Direct. This is the back end. You can go and upload that PDF for free. Upload it, get it all in there, fill out all the details that you need. I'll do a whole nother walkthrough of all that, but you can fill out all the details, and then your book is live within a couple days at minimum of 72 to 48 hours. And then you can do a couple different things. So what I've done is I've priced it the lowest possible. So this book can't be lower than $4.35, if you can see that. But that allows me, I don't make any money off of that. That allows me to ship this book anywhere around the world using Amazon Prime, anywhere in the United States, sure. The same one with this, right? So the hardcover, the minimum that this particular book here, which is a lot of pages. Did I put the page numbers in here? Didn't put the page numbers on there. Is the minimum that you can get a hardcover of that is for $12.34. And then the minimum you can sell it for is $4.59 for this size book. You don't make any money by doing that. Now, why would you do that? It's so that you could distribute your content through book form for very cheap. So there's a couple ways that I've done it where you could sell the book for $10 and then use this as a method of fulfillment, which probably is frowned upon, but you could send it as a gift and then they would know. Price was, unless you went and found it because it's live on Amazon right now for this price, if that makes sense. So you're not trying to like people, but it is a method that you can use to distribute things. So if you had a book, you could have bonuses attached to it. And then this is a way to ship a physical copy and get it in their hands within 2 days. And it only costs you $4.59. So for a lot of coaches, consultants, and people out there that are trying to write books, that's actually incredibly cheap to be able to get a book in someone's hands within 2 days, less, $4.50. For less than $5, you can have your book in someone's hands that they can read, which is pretty incredible. A book, I think I could actually sell it. I think that's actually the cheapest, the picture book, because this is fully all pictures and it's quite big. It's like quite large. I'm a large person. So one is a little bit more expensive because it's this kind of glossy type of picture book, but really cool still as well. So really the only, again, trick I got is go into AI and use deep research and it will go and basically look at all the sources it finds. It's incredible. It'll go and write you a really incredible book. And then you could expand on it. You could say, you know, add 10,000 words. Yeah. Good. And then let's see what it does. It'll probably add 10,000 words to that. So boom, it'll just keep going forever. You can add that. And then again, there's different sizes. The last little tip I got is you can go up to extensions here. If you can see this in Google Docs, and there's different add-ons you can get. One of them is called Page Sizer for Google Docs. That allows you to change the page size to any size. That way you can set the specific size that you want to use based off of whatever Amazon say you want to do. Because when you come in here and you, I don't know if I could show you, how do I show you that without creating all this? I think you gotta, yeah, certain sizes anyways that you have to utilize. And I was talking about this size right here, 5x5x8x5 is the main size that really readily available in Google Docs that you can print into. And then I believe that is this size right here. So this is a custom size. And then this is standard size in Google Docs. Oh, sorry. Let me change the thing here. This is standard size that Google Docs right now, if you set your book to 5x5 to 8x5, you can print out this size. And then this is a custom size that this is the smallest size that I think you can print on in Amazon, and you can see there's a difference. So I like this one because it pick it up. It feels a little bit more like a book because it's a little bit more smaller. Ones are a little bit bigger, but I think people, when they pick these books up here versus the smaller one, it has a little bit more legitimacy to it. I don't know. You know, you just pick up a book and you real book. Wow. Look at that. Anyways. So check all that out. Let me know if you got any questions. Again, 5x5x8x5 in Google Docs is a way to get it going out the box. And then Gemini for deep research looks like it's gave the most word count. So let me see if I could actually do a new one here. Let's see the difference between Google Gemini and ChatGPT for deep research on the same exact topic. What is the final word count? Final word count from ChatGPT was 1,762. And the final word count from Google Gemini was, wow, that is astronomical, guys. Okay. That is crazy. So basically, use Google Gemini to write books for you almost immediately. It's insane how much it actually does. I just said add 10,000 words, and it did, but I'm not really sure what this kind of fits into the whole overall context. So, of course, it needs help, but that is pretty incredible. So let me know if you got any questions. You might be able to find my books on here. I'm not sure if you would be able to, but they're on Amazon if you want to go check them out. Otherwise, let me know if you guys got any questions about anything. If you want some cool free resources for AI automation, learning how to do that, learn how to use N8N, things like that, go to my website, mikey.ai, and I got some free resources for you. Otherwise, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a great day.